trust in God than your confidence in man. Now, what a center. What a key scripture to have in your life. It's better to put your trust in God than your confidence in man. I thought that was wonderful. But then I wondered, what is the center of the Old Testament? Now, if you come tomorrow, I'll tell you. Just turn with me to 2 Chronicles. I've got to put my glasses on. These are small little words here. 20. This is the center of the Old Testament. The center of the New Testament, of the Bible is Psalm 118 verse 8. It's better to put your trust in God than your confidence in man. This is what the center of the Bible says. 2 Chronicles 20 verse 17. You will not need to fight this battle. Position yourself. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord who is with you. Now, in this scripture, the Hittites and the Termites and the Marmites and all those they came and they said to the king, they're like grasshoppers, they come in to attack us. Now, the Bible says Jehoshaphat was fearful. Now, don't get all religious. If everyone was coming to attack me, I'll also be fearful. But you see, there are emotions God has given us which are there for our good. Jealousy is emotion. It's wonderful. Fear is emotion. It's wonderful. But when it becomes an obsession, we have a problem. You see, I don't go too close to the edge of a cliff because I might fall. I don't put my hand too close to a fire. I could burn. You see, so but it's what you do with the fear. Mm-hmm. What did Jehoshaphat do? He called a prayer meeting. Yeah. You know, we will say, this is the wrong time to pray, brother. You've got to now strategize. You've got to get the army together. He called for a prayer, and they got in sackcloth and ashes, and they just humbled themselves before God. And the Lord's, there was a prophetic word said, you need not fight this battle. This is the middle of the Old Testament. And what happened? God set an ambush. And they sent the praise and worshipers out first. Isn't that great? And there was such a victory that God personally performed that for 3 days everybody collected the spoil.
Right.
You talk about being blessed. So Jehoshaphat discovered it's better to put your trust in God than your confidence in man. So here we have an example in the middle of the Old Testament what happens when you trust God. So I wondered, what is the middle of the New Testament? Now you've got to come on Friday. Acts 27. Listen, you won't believe this, what I'm going to share with you. Acts 27. Verse 17. When they had taken it on board, they used cables to undergird the ship. Fearing lest they should run aground on the Cyprus sands, they struck sail and were so driven. Now, in this particular portion of scripture, it's a story of shipwreck. The boat was about to sink, and yes, hopeless attempts to keep the boat afloat. Why? Because God gave Paul a word and said, don't sail. And the scripture says here in verse 11, nevertheless, the centurion was more persuaded by the helmsman and the owner of the ship than by the words that were spoken by Paul. And here we have in the middle of the New Testament an example of what happens when you trust man. You have shipwreck. Here we have an example in the middle of the Old Testament what happens when you trust God. You have victory. Here we have in the middle of the Bible that tells us it's better to put your trust in God than your confidence in man. Think that's coincidence? Wow. What a tremendous thing. It's interesting, there's 594 verses before Psalm 118 verse 8. 594 verses after. If you add them together, it gives you 1188. Psalm 118 verse 8. Wow. Huh?
Pretty cool.
Come on, it's cool. because we are students now and we're studying the Word, I know we're all looking for guidance. And I want to give you a foolproof way how to get guidance. Go to Psalm 119. Little verse of Psalm 119. Just go with me to Psalm 119. I'll show you something. Psalm 119 is the longest chapter in the Bible. Psalm 117 is the shortest chapter in the Bible. In between the two is Psalm 118. Now, Psalm 119, there's 176 verses. Each section is 8, because you have 26 letters in the Hebrew alphabet, Alpha Beta. It's interesting when you read that psalm, like the first few 8 verses start with A, the first letter of the Hebrew letter. The next 8 start with B, and so on. So it's an incredible psalm. But now I want to give you guidance. Turn to any place in Psalm, open your Bible, Psalm 119, and do this. Just do this. Yeah, do this. Then put your finger there. What did you get?
71.
Read it.
It is good for me that I was afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes.
It's good for me that I was afflicted, that I might learn your statutes. What did you get?
This is 118.
119.
119.
Let's do the test. Yeah, what do you mean?
My hands also I will lift up to your commandments, which I love, and I will meditate on your statutes.
Commandments, statutes. What did you get?
I'll have my Bible with you.
Oh, okay. What did you get, sister?
Psalms 15. I will meditate on your precepts and contemplate your ways.
Well, if we carry on, you're going to find, no matter where you go in the book of Psalm 119, you're going to get a synonym for the Word of God. Precepts, statutes, commandments, judgments, the law, these are all synonyms for the Word of God. In other words, the way to have guidance is to obey the Word.
Simple.
Isn't that simple, eh? Yeah. Isn't that profound? I figured it out by myself, eh? Want to get guidance, obey the Word of God. I thought once, I said to my congregation, let's learn Psalm 119. It's only 176 verses. And so I sat on it, and I only got 68 right. My secretary is a little Chinese lady, Jenny. She's half a pint. And she learned all 176 verses. I heard in Thailand they started a Bible school. But there were too many people in the Bible schools underground. So they said, okay, the intake policy is this. It's Friday today. Monday, all those that have learned Psalm 119 can start Bible school. You know what happened? Every single one learned Psalm 119.
Oh, wow.
Over the weekend.
Oh,
so for your next homework assignment.
I can't even remember what it is.
Nobody will see you tomorrow.
This little boy was in class and the teacher said, Johnny, what is 2 plus 1? He said, Jesus. So she said, what is 4 plus 3? He says, Jesus. He says, how do you get that answer? He says, no, when I was in church and my pastor said, Jesus is the answer. When I say it's better to trust God than put your confidence in man, it's better to trust God than put your confidence in princes. My wife and I have seen that. We have been through the most difficult and horrendous time in our life, but God brought us through. You know, it's not what happens to you that's so important. It's how you respond to what happens to you. That's important. So we often cry, woe me, look what I'm going through. But it's how you come through. That's important. And we have found that it is better to trust God and His Word than put your confidence in man. Men will fail you. Ministries will fail, but the Word of God will never fail you.
Amen.
So I'm excited that you're studying the Word. I'm looking forward to great testimonies. Enjoy the ISA. Enjoy CAM. Seen God do just some awesome things. Just in closing, a CAM group went out in a place called Kempton Park. It's a suburb of Johannesburg. and they went to flat to apartment number 13 instead of number 12. So they rocked at the, knocked on the wrong door, in inverted commas. And there was a guy with a gun to his head who was about to take his life. It was a Portuguese guy. And they led him to the Lord, he received Christ, got filled with the Spirit, joined an Afrikaans church, and now scanning with him.
Praise God.
I tell you, anything happens, you're involved in the ministry. The Lord bless you.